Yeah, yeah. This is the Friends television series Lego set, so what's the big deal?
Well, we made it into a modular, and the first floor is all done. Stay tuned. Hello, everybody. This is Dr. McBrick, and I'm here with my friends, MOC. That's right. It's not my friends, MOC. It's actually the Friends MOC set. You know what I mean. It's this, right? It's this. And so I am getting ready to build this MOC, and as you can see, I have a whole bunch of parts here that are all set up and staged. We're going to put this next to the sanctorum there, so I have it all set up on the base plate. I have all of my extra set here. So I have all the pieces in there just for extra pieces to add to this, plus these extra pieces here. Everything's gonna hopefully work together and we're gonna make it right. So in order to set it up though, I'll have to move that. I also have my iPad so I can actually watch all of you other Lego YouTubers out there while I'm building this MOC to get inspiration and or just to get entertainment. And anyway, the Sanctum Sanctorum set back there is what we're going to butt this particular set up to. So this part here will actually go on the back of that Sanctum Sanctorum. So it'll butt up to that and everything. So in order to do that, I had to position it on a base plate. Now, the easiest way to do that is just to kind of set it on the base plate where you want it. And I did back there. And then I put these little tiny studs, these translucent studs all around. So that way it keeps it in place. And it's kind of it's points that I have that I can use to build off of and things. And so if I take this off, I still have the actual footprint of this particular set. So that's what we're going to do there. I'll tell you what, as I look at this more and more, this part right here is going to be the toughest part. Now, I thought about building this up, but I think I might just cut this off and make an awning and then make the rest of the building or make a deck. I'm not really sure what. I'd like to continue to go on up, but to do that is just, at some point, I'm going to have to put a roof on this or a balcony or something. And so I got to figure out how to make it square. So I think what I'm going to start to do is, if you see, I left one stud row over here because this whole wall will probably be filled up with these bricks here so that it'll make it a nice pretty wall. This wall over here, I don't have to worry about so much because this is going to go up against the sanctum, and then this will be the door to enter to the cafe from the sanctum, so I don't have to worry about that. And it's this wall here that's going to have to be built up as well. I'll make probably an elevator shaft in here to go up and to actually carry minifigs up as opposed to a staircase. And so I'll probably come out here about 6 to 10 studs and make another wall. I'm not sure. I may or may not. But anyway, what I'm going to do is box this off. I'm going to take it from this wall over here and bring it over here and then box this off like this. And then this part here, wall in and figure out how to do this angle and stuff. So I better get my calculator out because there's going to be some math involved. Okay, let's take a look at what I've done so far. Let's first look at this back wall. Now, basically what I'm doing is just making a facade wall or another wall back here to cover all this up. So this wall will come up and this will be incorporated into the wall, and then it'll go up higher from that. But we just have to cover up this ugliness. I'll connect it in there with a 4x2, we just have to cover it up. But what I had to do here was I had to add, you see I added the masonry bricks just for the foundation, but I had to add the 1x plates to make up the difference between the base plate and the plates that are on this particular model. So that makes up the difference. Now, remember, this is not actually attached, like completely attached to every single stud underneath of here because of this angular piece right here. And, you know, my goal in all this is to keep the friend set exactly as is and just add on to it. And so in order to do that, I have to basically float this whole setup here on a base plate, which means I have to go up one plate thick. So a third of a brick, basically, I have to
go up. But you can see it's on there, and it is sturdy now, and it's floating, but it's stuck to several studs under here. And of course, all of this holds it in as well. Now, to do this part here in the back, I decided to go with stairs because the elevators take up a lot of bricks, and I just wasn't sure if I'm going to do three stories or not. So I just went up to the stairs. This area here will be our stairwell, stair area. So if I do go up to a third story, there'll be another staircase going up here and things like that. So that gives us a lot of room. I might do something. I always like doing something under my stairs when I build and stuff like that. I did masonry bricks again. Along here, I got it all evened up with the floor and all that kind of stuff, so it's all level, as you can see. And then I worked on this for over an hour trying to figure out how I could, you know, come out. I tried to come out here and go in. I tried to step it back, kind of boom, boom, boom type of thing, and all kinds of stuff. And it just didn't look good, in my opinion. So what I ended up doing was just taking it right here where the model ended, and just going straight over. And I went straight over, and then I'll just connect. I really won't connect, but it'll just be a wall here that'll go straight up as well. And then there'll just be kind of a little tiny, if you can see, a little tiny gap right there, which is no different for all of you who are being triggered right now. It is no different than the gap that Lego makes in their model as well. So, you know, that because of this wonderful angle, there have to be some sort of gaps. And so it's going to be a very minuscule gap, but nevertheless, it is there in that corner. Now, in order to put that wall in, if you recall that little table right there, that table was on a jumper and it was in the center of that jumper. Well, I just had to move it over and take the round jumper off and move it over to a stud and put the table right next to the couch, which still works magnificently if you ask me, but it wouldn't fit with that wall the way they had it placed. So that is one modification that I made to the particular model. So here it is, Central Perk in a modular style. Now I've put four walls on it, added everything I needed to add, and let's take a look and see what it looks like. Now if you recall, I had to float this model up onto this base plate. And so it means it's just probably, half of one of these, which is a third. So it's half of that, with that gap down there. Because I had to float it, I mean, it's on there, it's sturdy, it's not going anywhere, it's stuck to studs now, but it's floated and kind of tilted and everything like that. But because of that, I wasn't able to get tiles underneath of the actual structure. And so I have these studs sticking out. Now, before you're triggered or anything like that, for those of you who are stud averse, I am going to put some park benches right here. I'm going to put some jumpers in here, and then that way I can turn the park benches and put them on a diagonal and put them right there. So you really won't notice that when I'm done. The stairs were simply added. There's a couple of single studs under there that I took the stairs and tilted them and put them on the angle that I needed to. I know that's a pretty large step there for a minifig, but let's just go with it. Okay. So my question for the outside is, what do you think about these lights? I put the lights here. You know, I had them and I thought they kind of go with the trim and everything. So let me know what you think. Now, this sidewalk is obviously going to be changed based on my Sanctum Sanctorum, because remember, the Sanctum Sanctorum is going to come right in here and then be right here. So you are not going to see this wall. So I did not waste any bricks doing anything with this wall. This is the door you'll enter into the Sanctum Sanctorum, but that's where that's going to be. And there's just kind of a marker there that I had set down. So that's what it's going to look like. You know, they had these two tan bricks right here, and I didn't want to redo that wall or take those out. So what I did basically when I did this wall, I added those tan bricks as well. So that way it looks a little symmetrical with those tan bricks. Now let's go around to the sidewall here. Now remember, as I was constructing it, I could have come out and kind of made it, you know, on an angle right out here so it fit perfectly. But I didn't really have the bricks and the tiles and all the extra stuff that I would need to come out an extra, it would be three studs, I believe. And so I'm going with the gap. So mind the gap, don't worry about it. I apologize for it. But you know what, when you look at it, and when you're looking at it in Figsdale, it looks good, I think. And I don't think you're really going to notice that gap, especially once I do stuff around here and put some things around. Now, this wall, I could have done this wall flush, but again, what I wanted to do was add something. And let me show you what I added. That's right, I added a stage. And so now there is a stage inside of Central Perk. And that is where Phoebe and anyone else can sing or read poetry, all that kind of stuff. And so this little area here now goes onto a stage. I thought about doing the sports bar thing and putting a TV up there, but nah, I think Central Perk would probably on that wall have a stage or something like that, if not a couple booths. But I like the stage idea. So that fits really well. But the other thing that I did, because I really, really think this set is awesome and I hate to cover this set up and not have access to it. So what I did was I made this pop and open up. So it is a complete open wall. So I can get in there, I can photograph things, we could play in it. I have access to make scenes and all that kind of stuff. Now there's nothing changed in here with the exception of this piece right here. If you recall, this service sign was up coming out of this top stud, which was a stud on the side, it was way above the top of this level. So I had to bring it down one stud with this piece here. Now I'm gonna get a tan piece so it fits in the wall, but for purposes just today, I put that piece on there so you could see it. The other thing that I did, the only other modification I made, and I think I mentioned it earlier in this video, was put the table out one stud so that wall fit in here. I'm thinking about putting an elevator up in here, right here, because, you know, to get up to the second story, should I put a second story on it, I'm going to put an elevator right here, build this wall out, and there'll just be a hole right there, basically, that will pretend an elevator goes up. I could do a slider. I'm not sure if I'll get to that or not. But you know what? There's a gap right there where the hinges are, but I didn't want to sacrifice not having a wall that came off. And I could have done a pull-up wall, but I like having the structural soundness of having those hinges connected. The back wall is, as you see, and I think I showed you a little bit earlier, it's a solid wall. I think it looks fine. You know, it's not exciting or anything like that. But as we come around here, you can see that this is what this side looks like. It doesn't look too bad, to be quite honest with you. And, you know, in some ways, the texture looks kind of cool. Now, if I don't do the elevator inside here, I'm going to do a staircase on the outside and up into the second story. And that's the question I have for you. Should I build a second story or should I leave it like this and just put a nice roof on it and just make it a one-story building? I think that would look cool. It would look fine. It would certainly be easier and cheaper and not as much time, but a second story would look cool as well. Let me know what you think. Should I just leave it at this or should I build this into a second story? I'm only going to go two stories with this building just because I don't have the bricks. I mean, it cost a ton of bricks to do that back wall and tan and to do this and stuff. I mean, it was over 120 bricks to get all that in, plus all of the masonry bricks and things like that that I had to add. So don't really have a lot of the materials and stuff like that, but I will do a second story. If I do a second story, it's just going to be a rectangle. It's not going to be this part that jetties out. This will be a roof. It'll either go up or it'll just be a flat roof. And that's about all I'll do for that. So let me know what you think. Should I keep it like this? I think it looks pretty cool like this. If I put a flat top on it and an AC unit and all that kind of stuff up there, I think it would look kind of cool. But I also think it would look cool with an apartment as well. So remember that I am part of the BrickTubers Network. And please like this video, share this video if you're so inclined, and subscribe if you haven't. That's how you let YouTube know that you like my content and what I'm doing. And since I'm a part of the BrickTubers Network, all of the great BrickTubers, they can be found in the links in the description below. That's about all I have for now. I'll be making a second video with the second part of Central Perk. This is Dr. McBrick, signing out.